Straight tea.
No chaser.
No chaser.
If it's the tea I'm thinking well, of, it's the 40th anniversary of that tea.
Why, tonight's the very anniversary of that tea.
Yeah, I think it is the 40th anniversary of that tea.
What tea?
Petro's?
How's tea it World Fair?
Yeah, it's 40 years since World Fair. The
Petro's.
Yep.
Yep, go ahead.
I was going to say that the top of my head is cut off. It's not good.
Also in the stream.
Also in the stream. No, they're having the 40th anniversary celebration this weekend.
Yeah, I recently learned that Petro's was born at the World's Fair, mm-hmm. the Knoxville World's Fair, mm-hmm. and I didn't know the
Sun Sphere,
the great phallic symbol. Yeah, it's supposed to be like a proton, neutron, subatom. I don't know what it is. It's supposed to be some sort of part of a thing.
An atom.
It's a subatomic particle.
Yeah.
Part of all things.
A very, very tiny, tiny, itty bitty part.
Pick the science people.
We were trying to do the math a couple of years ago. We were trying to figure out if the Sun Sphere was to scale, you know, where would the planets be? You know, how far away would you need to be for the planets? And in order for, like, Mercury was, I don't know, somewhere in the middle of Tennessee, I think. I think it was further than that. But what's next? Venus? Yeah. I don't even know if Venus was in the United States. I don't remember. It was.
Was it? My very eager pickles 8.
Those
Jupiter
those
never, and Neptune.
Those never worked
like
for
that.
Me.
Apparently not me either.
Yeah. I think that's a fail.
Yeah, those mnemonic devices never worked for me.
Heath, can you check your gain, like increase it maybe 10%, just a little louder?
Gain incoming.
Little... Perfect. That sounds better. Did you do anything?
I raised my voice.
There we go.
That's a little bit of gain right there.
A little higher. How's this?
What's up, Coward? How you doing tonight? Or day? I don't know. Are you in Australia also?
I believe Tejas, right, Coward?
Tejas?
I believe so.
Texas.
Tejas Navidad.
I believe.
No. That's not how that works at all.
I believe Coward is the consumer of barbecue. That makes it work. I don't know what that is a response to. Yes, he is in Tejas.
Oh, I had so until I saw it written down, I had no idea what that even was.
Tejas Navidad.
That's hilarious.
Have you all looked at Monsters of the Multiverse?
No.
Is it out?
What is it?
The new thing, yes it is.
Did not. Oh. That's
it is out.
That's on my unbirthday list. I'm getting it tomorrow.
It is out. And what were those other two? Just one second, and I will tell you. Mordenkainen's Tomb of Foes and Volo's Guide to Monsters are discontinued.
Bum, bum, bum.
Well, good news. I've already got both.
Yeah. Yeah,
I've got them on digital and not digital. What does that mean? Like, did they incorporate all that into one book or what?
They did. So, like, for instance, I'm looking at Yith Yankee in Multiverse.
And?
And okay. It's different. It's pretty different.
I'm glad they're putting it in one book because I hated having... I didn't like how they separated those two things. So, it should have been one big book.
Turning pages is exhausting.
Well, you don't remember which book it's in. Like, there's great information in both of them, and I can't remember, is it in this book or this book? Because...
Yeah.
And in some of the books, like, Yith Yankee is in both books, but one has, like, a 6-page dissertation on the history of Yith Yankee, and the other one's, here's your PC race, you know?
Here's the thing, that one of the complaints people are having about Monsters of the Multiverse is it doesn't have all that stuff.
Yeah.
So if you want the dissertation on the Blood War, you're going to have to look in Mordenkainen's.
Oh,
you're not going to. It's not inside the new
But that's
Monsters of the Multiverse.
That's always what happens, right? I mean, half of the 5e books don't contain like a 10% of the lore that was in the previous edition's books.
Yeah. So they've discontinued, so you no longer can get those other two by legal means?
So on D&D Beyond, I don't think you can purchase them any longer.
Oh.
But I'm sure if you go to your used bookstore, you can buy them, of course.
Right, right. And I think I already have them on D&D Beyond.
Oh, yeah, look, they're listed as discontinued.
But yeah, if you go to DDB and try to buy it right now, it's not going to, I don't think it'll let you buy it.
Well, that's just crap.
It's very sad.
Yep. But like,
I guess we're just replacing it.
Like at the very top, it's like creating your character, ability score increases. You get your +2/+1 and any score you want, or 3+1s. So the races themselves no longer have stats. Like Githyanki used to have strength and int, no more. Mm-hmm. You get the, you know, choose your own stat method for all races.
Well, like Tasha's, Tasha's did that.
Exactly. Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I wonder, is this part of the lead up to the kind of 5.5 that they've been talking about?
Sounds like
it. Yeah, that's, yep, 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 yep.
Yeah. And are they incorporating, it may not matter for whatever's in this book, but are they incorporating using your proficiency bonus as a tool for abilities per day, like they have started with Tasha's in the newer books?
I haven't found a race that has that kind of ability yet. I'm just going to scan through here really quick. How about I do a search for proficiency bonus?
That was just a really good idea. That's a great way to scale it to level, you know, like you start with two. And
okay,
you're a
level, so yep, here's six. One right here. Asimar, healing hands. As an action, you can touch a creature and roll a number of d4s equal to your proficiency bonus. Creature gains a number of hit points equal to the total roll. So yes, they're doing that.
That's a lot of d4s. Actually, no, it's not.
It's a very manageable number of d4s, in fact.
It's a very manageable number of d4s, yeah.
Yeah, all of the Asimar abilities are based on proficiency bonus.
Hey, so Raisin, how are you?
Raising Rune Lords.
Yep.
Oh, oh,
that reminds me, we have chat. I can switch to the new scene that I made. Boop. There we go.
You're making a scene?
Yes, I'm making a scene.
Transition.
I put the chat in the middle of our
I like BSing. It. Very cool.
The Eldarin, you know how they had that face step? What was it, per short rest?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Now it's proficiency bonus times per day.
Wow.
That's better.
That's much better.
Yeah.
That's
immediately better. Yeah.
Yeah,
that was one of those skills that I always wanted to use it to get in and then get out of somewhere. Mm-hmm. And so I would always keep it for the ability to escape at a moment's notice. Mm-hmm. And so it never got used.
Yeah.
But having it multiple times a day means as long as you always keep one around, you're okay.
Yep.
You can bounce around.
It's a great ability. I really enjoy it.
That character in particular, I think I had a conversation with every player in the game saying, would it be okay if my character stabbed your character and ran away?
How polite.
Well, I wanted to get consent before my character went mental.
And Luminous Gru is here tonight.
All right.
What's up, Luminous?
Kind of.
I got absolutely sucked into this TV show that's on Netflix. I watched, I think, 4 episodes just without even thinking. And it's a game show, and it's called Is It Cake? Anybody heard of this stuff?
Yeah, I've seen the ads for it.
I so guess.
They get 3 of these professional cake designers to design a cake that looks as realistic as, you know, they give you an option of a handbag or a bucket or blah, blah, blah. And they have to make this, and these 3, I guess, B, C, D lister celebrities come up and try to guess which one's cake.
Yeah.
And once they decide, they take a knife and they stab it to see if it's cake or not. I mean, I couldn't get enough of it. I'm like, why? You know, and then they, of course, they go, if there's a tie, like 2 people deceive the judges, they have to go eat the cake and decide which one wins based on taste and, I guess, visual, like the how well it deceived them. Man, I did. I just sat there and, like, before I knew it, I'd seen four episodes, and I'm like, oh my God, I'm watching a show about cosmetic cake.
And now I'm hungry.
Yeah.
And now I want cake.
For the people in the Twitch chat, one of the four of us is cake tonight.
Do not stab us, please.
Oh, that's funny. That's funny. There's a I've seen cake. A Japanese version of it, and it's like, is it chocolate or something like that? And I just see clips of it, and it's people just biting random things. Like, there's this one where there's like a door handle, one of those lever action door handles, and the guy's like, he chomps down on it. He's like, ugh, you know.
And I just, my teeth hurt just thinking about that.
Right. It's amazing what they can make out of confection.
Takeshi's Castle for those country. People. I suspect there's some hefty waivers you have to sign before you do any of those things.
Sure.
Yeah. Have you ever seen the Chris Farley Saturday Night Live skit where he goes on a Japanese game show and he doesn't speak any Japanese? So he has no idea what's going on, but he keeps accidentally getting the answers right. And Mike Myers plays the guy running the game show, and it's amazing.
No, I've not seen that.
I keep telling you, I don't speak Japanese. The concierge said, did I want to go to a Japanese game show? I didn't think he meant beyond the Japanese game show.
Oh, that sounds funny.
Well, Heath, you are the cake.
I am the cake. Okay.
Choo-choo-ka-choo.
So, one of the YouTubers that my girls like to watch, or used to like to watch, I think it's called Let's Cake It or something like that.
Okay.
And it was the other way around. She's like, I'm going to make a cake of XYZ. And she would show you how she makes the cakes.
Okay.
And they look like the real object, but they're cake, you know. But you see her through the whole process of making it. And they just, like, would watch it. I mean, like, hundreds of episodes.
People with talent. Way too much talent.
And cake.
And cake. Yeah.
What?
Baking paraphernalia.
Yeah, and so one of the things that the baker would do is it's a technique. It's called crumb coat,
okay.
Which is, like, a really, like, thin layer of icing to like make sure the crumbs stick to the cake. So when you do the real icing, it's not like smeared all over the place.
I've heard of this.
Yeah. So she would crumb coat it and then stick it in the refrigerator to chill.
Okay.
And so that was crumb coat and chill, right? Well, the girls were always crumb coat and chill. It's like, you know, I'm just going to wait here. I'm going to crumb coat and chill, you know.
That's funny.
Sounds like a cool piece of liquor.
That's good.
If we start using band names, kids will stop though. So.
Yeah,
exactly.
I was going back and I was telling the guys before we went live that I'm listening to the podcast, kind of just going back, seeing what I remember and pick up. And there was a point where we were talking about a band name, which was Aluminum Skeletal Zed.
Yep.
Do I remember talking about that?
Oh, yes.
Aluminium Skeletal Zed. Yeah.
Yep.
That sounds like a micism.
So that crumb cake, whatever you just said, sounds like another band name.
Crumb coat and chill. She was from Canada.
We've if we gather enough of them, we'll be able to run around like Lollapalooza.
We'll sell posters.
Yep. We'll make tens of cents.
I think we'll probably lose tens of cents.
At least 3 drachma.
Yeah, I was going to say tens of drachma.
I still haven't figured out exactly the conversion of drachma to gold bars. Like, I don't know how many drachma or how many gold bars are in a drachma, you know?
It's pretty easy. I have 1 drachma, and I'm not giving it to you, so it's priceless.
Division by zero. We win.
When you first got that, you posted it on here. You need to send me if you still have it, a link to get one of those. I want to buy me a drachma.
I'll find it. That's a patron stretch goal. For people at the highest tier, we'll send you a drachma.
International sales do apply. Or shipping.
It weighs nothing.
So you stick it in
the envelope. I could probably throw this one and it'll reach you.
It's pretty impressive.
That's impressive.
Not only in power, but in trajectory, it's impressive.
Yeah. Look, it's in orbit.
Mm-hmm.
It's the blood moon. No, it's a drachma coming from Australia.
Yeah, that's how you reach space. Fly sideways really, really fast.
Yeah.
Completely counterintuitive.
To be fair, I only have to get it to go up, and then the Earth rotates underneath it, and then it has to come back down at the right time. So,
oh man, you have the drachma tier of Patreon support.
Orbital so drop high, drachma.
We haven't even orbital, listed.
Yes. Orbital. There's the next band name for you.
Yes,
there it is. And the award for new music video goes to Orbital Drachma.
Yet another band name. God, I'm going to write this down. That's three. Do you guys remember what happened last time?
T-Rex, and it's a zombie.
What we were doing? A zombified T-Rex, which I saw the previews for the new, what was it?
I don't know.
The park.
Jurassic Park.
Park. Dollywood, no.
You know, yeah, it doesn't look too bad. Looks better than the last. You say
there's a zombie T-Rex in it, and they're ripping us off.
Spoilers. Actually, I watched Doctor Strange on Sunday.
Still didn't say no.
The only thing I'm going to say,
I kill you.
It is not spoilers at all. Is if you don't like Sam Raimi movies, you will not like this movie.
Okay, I don't know what that means.
Yeah, I've heard that's fine.
Otherwise, yeah, Army of Darkness, Evil Dead, Darkman, like Raimi did all these movies, and they're like Darkman. Comedy, like goofy horror kind of thing. Yeah,
Drag Me to Hell.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So anyway,
what about Big Trouble in Little China? Is that one? That's not him, is it?
I don't know. I don't think it's Sam Raimi.
No, that's not him.
Okay,
that is somebody else.
Okay.
I just found out that I believe that is on Disney Plus.
Which? Oh, really?
Big Trouble in Little China, yeah.
Oh,
which, again, that is a John Carpenter joint.
John Carpenter, that's right.
Who is your Halloween assault on Precinct 13, the thing, Christine?
So it's always interesting when you see certain directors always pull the same actors, because John Carpenter did The Thing, and you got, what's his face, that did both of those.
The Thing guy.
Jeff Goldblum?
And then, yes. Kurt Russell. And then you've got
from New York.
Alien and Terminator. They both have like several actors in both movies, bit parts.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's just always cool. And then you got like Happy Gilmore dude that gets all of his buddies in every movie he ever makes.
You can do it.
Yeah. So, giant T-Rex biting you, killing you. Trathiel, go.
Kill it back. Kill it back.
Just like your Discord.
Return fire.
Return fire.
It is the top of round three.
Keep firing, assholes.
You guys have been pounding the crap out of this thing.
Wait a minute.
And it is still going full tilt. You got your boys involved in it, Ed Jar and Thistle and Sakura. Berzon, you're going toe-to-toe. This thing, I don't think this thing's hit you yet, has it? Maybe a tail slap?
Hasn't bit him yet.
Has not bit
I
you
I think
yet.
There was a tail slap.
Yeah.
It hit hard, too.
Yeah, and that was, yeah. And also, it's very obvious that this thing has pretty massive reach. You know, just looking at the icon itself is telling that it's, you know, 15 or, what, 25 feet wide and 40 feet tall. The thing's massive. So, Tarathiel, it is your turn.
I'm going to throw a psychic knife at this thing. I'm just wondering, do I have a clean shot?
I'm sure there's like 20 feet of it sticking out over, you know, everybody.
Yeah, it's up in the air.
You know what? Right. Good call.
So, in theory, it's tall.
I completely forgot about that. So, all ranged attacks, no longer. I didn't think about that. This thing's like 40 feet tall. So, no cover on ranged attacks because of the angle. Yeah, you're good.
All right, and I'm hidden as well, right? Because I've been stealthing when I step back into the shadows. Been using my bonus action to hide.
Yeah, you've been guerrilla warfaring it.
Well, then it's probably unprepared for this. Sweet. It's a 22 to hit for 15 total damage.
Is that with sneak attack?
Yeah, a natural one on the sneak attack. So
gross. Okay.
What? Seven from the dagger, eight from the fact that I got it right in a soft part of its eye. And then I'll slink back into the shadows again. I'll remain hidden.
All right.
Fine. I'm wearing a cloak, so I get
advantage. This thing's never gonna see you.
Nope.
Like I, no joke. I think its perception's like six.
That's a 20, a not natural 20, but a 20 to be hidden. What is this music I have found? I'm gonna turn that off.
you're also in control of a henchman.
Oh, so I am.
Hench away.
Which one are you in control of? I was doing
Sakura.
Sakura.
Strawberry.
So he will fire off a longbow shot. Longbow, shortbow.
Yes,
longbow. D8.
So I don't know what the bonus is on it, but it's a 12 on the die.
It's got plus 4. I don't know why I haven't been telling you, but it's got plus 4. He has plus 4 to hit. That's a 16, and that is a... Oh, yeah, that's a hit.
Okay. And one D8 damage. I don't know if you
guys have noticed, thing's got a really low armor class.
Yeah, I figured it's huge. It's going to be difficult to miss. So that's 5. 5 piercing damage. As an arrow comes flying out of the dark, Sekiro will stay there, though, because there's just no way I'm getting any closer to this thing. It doesn't seem necessary.
You rolled a 5, so that's 7 points of damage. Okay.
Yeah.
That's piercing. Okay. That is it for you guys. Fairzone, it is now your turn.
Fairzone checks the volume level on Sirenscape. Oop, there it is. Okay. and he is going to... And last time he had taken note of how sharp and pointy the teeth were and how numerous there were. And he pulled out his shield and that plus one flail.
Yes,
so he is going to continue beating on it with the flail. All
right.
So
continue
beat away.
Yes, hopefully he's going to beat.
Continue flailing
rapidly. Yes flailing. 16 should hit, I think.
Hit,
and that'll be 7 points of damage. Not a lot. Right. And second attack with the flail coming around with the backhand. 15.
Hit,
and that'll be 11 points of damage.
Right.
So this thing, I know it's not. So I know it's not bloody, but
well, just about to say, with that last flail hit, it has just become bloodied.
Excellent. All right,
and ridiculous.
And ridiculous at
the same time.
Yes, you guys have done a tremendous amount of damage to this thing. Is that it for you, Faison?
I think that is. Yeah, I can't use my bonus action to hit him because that's a polearm thing. What I need is a really long flail. That's what I really need.
You got a dude too.
Yeah, I'm just going to stay where I am, and I think Thistle is my guy, right?
Yes,
I believe Thistle. Yeah. Yep. Okay, so that's going to be a d20 plus 4. You say.
Yes.
And that's a 15. Hit. So
this thing has an 11 armor class. I think you've kind of narrowed it down, so it's easier if I just tell you.
Nice. Okay. And the D8 for the damage is a 2.
So 4 points.
So 4 points. All right. Damage. And Fairzon, looking kind of over his shoulder at the where everyone is located, because this thing is so tall, he doesn't need to move to kind of get out of the way of anything.
No, I didn't take into account its height. There is no cover for anybody's ranged weapon at this point.
Okay. That's not me. but I don't think there's anything else I can use my bonus action to do, so I'm going to stay where I am.
All right, Khaldun.
Khaldun's going to hurl a bolt of flame at it.
Okay. Roll.
Hurl a 14 to hit.
That's it.
That's a hit. 14 points of fire damage.
Nice. Nice.
And then as a bonus action, he's going to roll that ball of flame up right between his legs.
Roll that tail.
Hey. Cloaca.
So that'll be a dex save.
Dex save. Fail.
Nice dex save.
All right.
It does not move quickly at all.
It takes 12 more points of fire damage. Cooking.
Bacon, rotten flesh. Yummy.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. So that little ball is just like doing figure eights between his lips.
Right. It's like, well, you've got it set up as like this tiny little dude, right? Like a little.
Yeah.
So I just see him just like ramming his head into
the wall. Yes, exactly. He's like, head-biting. It's like doing the sumo thing.
That's great. It sounds like the little guy that flips the. In the labyrinth, when she writes the arrows on the block and like flips it over. All right. You are in control of Ajar.
Yes, Ajar is going to take a shot. 7 plus 4 is 11. I think that's a hit.
That's a hit. That's a hit.
5 on the die.
Okay. That's 7. Got it.
And we are done.
All right, it is Señor Zombie's turn. And it's very single-minded. It's not paying attention to that fire. It's not really smart enough to do that. It's just continuing to attempt to pound on Ferzon. So we'll go with the first attack. We're going to do the tail attack first. 16, probably a miss.
That is a miss, and I would like to riposte.
Oh, righty.
Repost.
And let me see. Make sure I'm doing this right. 21.
Nope, that looks wrong.
That looks wrong. Yeah, right. So that is going to be go away. So I need to add a D8 to this. It's a 6. It's a low roll. But it's 5 more, so that's 11 points of damage on that.
All right.
So it's a duck and a dive and a smack.
He counter reposts your repost with his bite.
It's not very nice.
And
everyone, you get a reaction. You get a reaction.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that loud?
That is his bite, and I don't think a 19 hits, does it?
Nope.
All right. This thing is a one-trick pony. Pazel, would you like to swim down the gullet of the zombified tree rats?
No, not at all. But it will fly up its nose.
Okay. Same size.
Tarathiel's hidden, so he's going to have a nice shot at the T-Rex. So she's just going to... Well, you know what? We don't know what else the heck is going on here, do we? This area up above north of Tarathiel, is that like a dead end there, that little cave area?
You can walk around this. He's standing almost in the rubble. It's a very large pile of rubble, but it looks like he can go around it.
Well, I think he actually went up here and looked around and then came back.
I don't think nobody's looked down in this area yet. Because the rubble's very tall. Nobody's actually stepped up here that I know of.
I don't think I made it all the way around. I think,
you did? Okay. All right. Well, I am going to send Pazel like right there.
All right.
Just let me to look.
Let Rouge me hunting. Open that up real quick.
Find a very angry lich gnoll.
So it looks like it loops
as
back
opposed
around.
To the. Cute and cuddly lich gnoll.
I mean, I prefer cute and cuddly lich gnolls.
Oh, okay.
This must
more.
Be Liam.
That's Liam to go with the gnoll. That's a large stalagmite that is blocking that sight.
Wonderful. See, I hate stalagmites.
Sorry.
Isn't that the stuff you put on the toast?
No, it's Vegemite.
Oh, okay. My bad.
So something that I forgot about is I think I need to do another dex save for the damage from the fire thing.
Oh, at the end of the turn. Yes, that's right. Yes, that's correct. TX rules.
TX rules. I think that's fail. So
Doyle rules.
Do some damage. Doyle McDoyle or Doyle rules.
11 points of flaming toe damage.
All right. Anything else?
No,
let's pause Zell's turn, really.
Done.
All right, top of round four, Tarathiel.
All right, I'm just going to keep doing it because it seems to be working.
Yeah. Pretty hard to miss this thing.
Fires a missile. for some reason, it didn't roll with advantage, but it's still got a 26.
You want to check for a crit?
Let me fish for that crit. No, so it would have been a 20 either way. For a total of 17 damage.
Ooh wee, man, you are.
That was a hard one on the side.
Son of a so and so.
It was a one on the blade, but then a 12 on the critical leg. The critical leg. I've been by. All right.
Did you know? Last night, I learned that there is a language called Berber.
Berber?
No. Yeah, I've heard of Berber.
Is it
Grant Berber?
It is a North African dialect spoken in the mountains where mountains of Algeria. I had a guy come into the bar last night, like 2:45 in the morning. French guy. Anyway,
he spoke Berber.
Six languages.
Order a drink.
He spoke six languages, and one of them was Berber. I had never heard of it. So
was one of them English?
Yes. Yeah. It was like his fifth language.
Jeez, that's wild. So I'm guessing.
I work with a bunch of multilingual people, and I'm super impressed by them because I can barely speak one language.
Right. Right. I used to work at an international lab, and it was, or I used to work at a place that a lot of international people would come to before they would go on to like bigger and better things. And I'd walk into lunch on Fridays, and there would be at least half a dozen languages going on. It was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
It was great. Anyway, go on.
Well, if you're living in countries the size of our states, you're just going to hear all these languages. It's just impossible not to speak them.
Yeah.
I'm a little jealous. It'd been cool. I'd like to be able to speak other languages, but I don't want to spend the time to learn.
Well, we had a friend.
I'd like to just magically have it.
Who was from Corsica, and he spoke. He spoke five or six languages, and I asked him about it, and he says, I learned it on TV. It's like you flip a channel, it's in a different language.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you can just flip through there, and just, it's
your immersion. And his name was Henri Casanova.
Yes.
That is really his name.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Henry. Doctor.
Doctor Henri Casanova.
Of course.
Who moved to California to surf and teach somewhere. Yeah. He's a neat guy. He also played the piano like Mozart and swam 15 miles a day. Like, he's just one of those guys that just blows you away with everything he does.
Yep.
All right. Sakura's putting an arrow into this thing. That's
Sakura, go ahead.
D20 plus 4, you said, right? Plus 4?
Correct. Plus 4.
Boom.
That's
13
hit.
To hit.
Plus 2 to damage. Okay.
Plus 2 to damage. 5.
5.
Peace on.
Right. Still.
Oh, wait. I need to hide again. Although I'm sure it will be fine.
I'm sure it's fine.
Okay.
I'm sure it's fine.
Sure it's fine. Why is my...
dishes are still standing. 27. Oh,
that'll do.
27.
Yeah, he's literally like plane shifting here.
Yeah. Yeah. You're a wisp of smoke that's shooting out purple daggers of thought.
That's right. I'm going to be the shadow conjuration that Calderon brings up. Yes. Right. He's gonna summon a shadow conjuration, and Tarathiel's just gonna step out. What's up?
All right, Mr. Fezzine, it's your turn.
Oh, already? That was quick. Okay. He's going to
messing around.
Flail about. 14 should hit.
Hit.
And with 10 points of damage, and keeping it real with 23 on the second one for 12 points of damage.
So your first hit.
Uh huh.
Flail, smack. It starts collapsing.
Okay.
All right.
He's going to keep hitting it.
And how much damage did you do?
The first hit. First one is 10 points of damage.
10 points of damage. Mm-hmm. So you hit it. It looks like it's starting to collapse. Gets its leg underneath itself.
Mm-hmm.
And rights itself back up.
Okay. I don't like it.
Go ahead with your turn.
Yeah, he's going to aim a little lower on the skeletal structure this time. And with I rolled a 23 on the second attack.
That's a hit.
And 12 points of damage.
12 points of damage. Again, you hit it like a good solid hit. And this thing is falling apart. All these arrows, the psychic damage, the fire, it's cooking, it's burning. You're smacking it. Its pieces are falling left and right. You hit it and it loses its balance. Almost falls over. And tumbles to the ground. And lies still.
Hooray!
Give me a dexterity saving throw.
Dang it. This is against the giants all over again. do I have to?
No, you can voluntarily fail.
Absolutely not.
9. I'm getting my German practice today.
9's fine. 9's fine. It was a low DC. Okay. But just, you know, there's a slight chance it falls your way and you don't get out in time. Uh-huh. So it falls towards you and you step aside. And it crumbles into a mass of cracking bone, burning, disgusting, rotten flesh, and continues to cook with the little red dude headbutting its ass over and over.
It's a little red dude. You don't know what you got.
So I'm going to do this.
No, he's doing a victory dance.
Because this thing lasts in rounds, your flaming sphere, right? It lasts for like a minute, right? Yep. We're going to continue in rounds, okay? We're just going to go ahead and continue in rounds to see where you are to allow you to get the full advantage of the full casting of that spell, okay? So, Fairzon, you attacked twice.
Mm-hmm.
It's still your turn. You have a move and a bonus action.
Okay. He stows the flail and shield, pulls out his magic steak, and starts stirring the bones around, looking, making sure it hadn't eaten anything valuable.
All right, give me a perception check.
Perception check is going to be...
You're
going to
have Thistle do anything?
15 on the perception check, and Thistle is going to stay right where he is. If there are any crannies or nooks about, he's going to just kind of... take a look and make sure there's nothing sneaking up on him or anything like that.
Okay, so is he going to do anything? Is he like preparing an action? Is he going to move? Is he, what is he going
to
do anything?
To the northwest of Khaldun, is that a passageway or is that just a kind of a nook or cranny?
That's just a bad reveal.
Okay.
It's a mega cranny.
Okay.
Mega. Yeah. It's a very sharp corner.
All right. Then Thistle will step around just to the southeast of Fairzon, just kind of looking over his shoulder.
Okay. So he does see a bit of an opening going back into a cavernous area back there.
Okay. So when he does see that, he will kind of like tap Fairzon on the shoulder, like, there's something over here, so Fairzon will be on the lookout or just be aware. So, but he doesn't have any movement or anything left to.
You finish stirring up the guts of this T-Rex and don't really see anything of value.
Okay.
Just more and more. Maybe what it ate as its last meal when it was alive, like some other animal, but nothing of value.
Okay. Fairzon will, across the telepathic link, say, "The lizard, the giant thunder lizard, is down, but there is a passage to the south of us."
And honestly, from your perspective, you can also see that this passage continues on to the west. Now that this creature's down, you're not so focused on it. That's you. All right, we're going to go on to Khaldun.
All right.
This is round four.
Okay.
Just saying, it's round four.
All right. see. So I see Ferzan has examined the skeletal creature.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I think I'm going to see if I can't move around the corner in this direction. So
I missed it. I didn't see it.
Here.
Oh, gotcha. All right. Show me where you go.
One, two, three.
Hot.
Yes. Four.
It's going to hot.
Five. Hot, six. That's a move.
Okay.
Anything interesting?
Nope, nope. You still really haven't seen much more than already revealed.
One, two, three. Can I see more?
You sure can. Wait. Gotta open this up. The tunnel continues on around and veers south a bit. Let me see. You gotta see. You can see more than that. Not much, but
two pixels.
Yeah, but you can see that it continues on south, though. Is what I'm trying to get at. It's not like a dead end.
Okay. That's three, four.
It's a living end.
Five, like six. Bank.
All right. So go back four. Go back to four because I'm going to open it up a bit more, and you may want to change your mind.
Okay.
So you four get pixels. A better angle. You come over here. All right. These pixels are more important. You come around the corner, and you did not mention anything about stealth.
Okay.
You see... Ah. Oh, you probably can't see that. Do you see that?
I see it.
Yeah, I see it.
Okay.
I do now.
All right. So you go around the corner... The only thing
we can see is what we're meant to see.
You go around the corner, and you... Give me your stealth check anyway, just to see how loud you are. You know what I mean?
Yeah, sure.
You're not trying to be stealthy, so just kind of give me an idea. Okay. You come around the corner, and you see a large creature. Mm-hmm. And it's pretty obvious through... You may not have seen one in person, but you've read a book or you've heard stories of ogres, right?
Okay.
But this ogre is dilapidated and rotten and... slowly turns its head and looks towards you as you come around the corner.
Well, hello there.
So you still have the rest of your move. You did not move further down. That's why I was like, hang on, let me tell you what's going on before you charge forth into the loving grasp of a ogre zombie.
Who else's brain so, went?
Kenobi.
You just happened to have that there, didn't you?
It's been sitting on my desk for a while.
Heath, what are you using for light?
I am using my light ring of light.
So it's a total of 40 feet, right?
Yes. Dim light out to 40.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha. Just want to get you your full vision.
So I don't see all the other crap in there then, is what you're trying
correct.
To tell me.
That's okay. What I'm saying.
Good to know. All right. So I am going to backpedal. The two remaining squares.
Back patio.
That too. So that's my full move there because I moved. Hero I point. Moved twice.
We don't use hero points, but you can have one.
Yes.
And I am going to roll sunbeam over there using a bonus action. He can move 30 feet. So one, two, three. Four, that's kind of warm. Five, six. There we go.
It's like Chris Tucker. Hot.
So and your fire also sees a zombie.
Oh, it's excited. It likes zombies. And I communicate over the mental net here that we've got company.
Beedy, 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 beedy,
more zombies.
It ain't over yet. All right. Yes. You have
a jar. Yes, a jar. I am a jar. Okay. And so a jar is like, he doesn't really know what's going on, but he's going to follow, just keep an eye on me.
He's not a part of the International Psychic Network, but it's a free action for somebody to go, hey, you know, something's going on if they want to.
Yeah.
You're needed so to the
five,
west.
10, 15,
a jar, please.
20,
come to the western exit.
25, 30. So he's going to stop there, and then he is going to ready action to fire his bow if anything comes into view to fire at. Like
sounds good.
An ogre zombie.
Like an ogre zombie. Just for instance.
Yes.
Spitballing here.
All right. So just remember that because I probably won't keep up with that. Okay.
Okay. All right.
A jar to the ogre desk. A jar to the ogre desk.
Yes.
Puzzle.
Puzzle's looking for something to eat. So she's going to fly down right about there. And just, you know, see if there's anything
else
to see there.
She can see forever.
And a little more.
Sorry?
Forever,
a
little more
than forever. Yeah. All right, let's get this
party
blown
started.
Wide open. Bam.
Fun.
Oh, crap.
Those are humanoid. Humanoid. Human. They're actually human. Zombies. Have you sensed the theme yet?
Huzzah!
No. I don't know what's going on here.
Sense of theme of our wizard is trying to get us killed.
Everyone knows you can't.
Well, they don't necessarily.
You can kite all of the encounters together into one big rolling encounter.
Well, she's not giving off any light, but she continues to fly down. Down here.
I'll go this way.
Yeah, she's got dark vision. She's 50 feet away. Where did she go?
Right here. I'm pinging.
I'm clicking on the wrong thing. I'm a jagger. Well, how did I do? There we go. God almighty. Okay. Okay. So she's back to the beginning. Nothing new there.
No. She just kept on flying.
Okay. All right. So at that point, the ogres begin to move.
Ogres.
Oh. Yeah. You're about to see them.
Huzzah!
One, squeeze, two, three, four, five, six.
It's too many.
So this narrow area, it had to turn sideways to get its shoulders. Oh, it didn't really. It's dumb. So it scrapes its shoulders and some of the skin and flesh
takes
falls
47
off
points of damage.
Takes 47 points of non-lethal damage. But it does have reach. And I think, yeah, it's within 10 feet. So it lumbers forward, gets within reach of you, and reaches out to
touch
say hello.
Me.
What we got? What's your plus to hit? 15. Wow, I think that's going to hit.
15 to hit?
That's a miss.
Whoa.
Steve.
Natural
the Tarrasque ogre zombie.
Let's hear it, Mike. And then the Tarrasque showed up, or what does he always say?
That's about the time the Tarrasque showed up.
Yeah, that's right. No, it missed wildly.
Good.
But behind it is another one that gets into the squozing part. But you can't really see, but you hear it coming up.
They're squozing now. Good.
It's squozing. And that's it for them. Yeah, those zombies that Pazel saw really don't have a chance to see her or hear or anything like that. So they're good. It is now the top of round five, and it is Tarathiel's turn.
Run! All right, so I've heard that Keldon is in trouble. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. This is the best part about podcasts, is listening to people count to 30. 20, 25. All right, I should be able to see it from there. So I'll take a
clear shot.
Movement, yep. Movement, cunning action to dash, and then I will chuck a psychic dagger at this thing.
All right.
I think you're still hitified, aren't you? You haven't done anything
I'm moved and ended somewhere
break
where I would be clearly
yeah,
visible.
Cause he was kind of hiding behind a wall, and then he ran through bright light, you know.
Yeah, jumped over a flaming gnome.
Oh, he's definitely. Oh, you know what? He's definitely in bright light where he is right there.
I knew I would be.
Flamey boy.
I wanted to back you up.
Thank you. You are.
That's an 11 to hit.
11 to hit. is a hit.
Holy crap.
Oh, well, that will do 10 psychic damage then.
All right.
That's maximum psychic damage, which I'm pretty happy with.
Hooray.
And then Sakura will move up as well.
Oh, I apologize. Sorry, Tarathiel. I have a reaction with a jar here in a second. Because the zombie stepped in.
Yes. Yes, you do.
Because zombies.
Can Sekiro see it from there?
Yeah, this thing's a whole bunch bigger. It's kind of the same thought process as the T-Rex. Khaldun's not really blocking half its body. These are big ogres. You know, they're like 8-9 feet tall.
19 to hit will probably work.
That's a hit.
3 points of piercing damage as an arrow comes flying out of the darkness.
Did you add 2 or roll a 3?
I did. I rolled a natural 1 and I added 2.
Yeah. All right. Just check. All right.
I got it.
Anything else?
Weep gently, for my body will soon be broken. But otherwise, no.
All right. Fair's on. Oh, wait, yeah.
Can take I your, take a reaction? Yep. Reaction. Yep, go for it. Yep. There we go. 3.
It is not a hit.
I am sensing a pattern.
Well done, sir.
Yes, he had his bow out and he saw the big ugly thing sort of try to reach out and give me a hug, and it's like, oh crap.
Earning his money well. How many
smacks does it take to get to the center of a Khaldun?
Yes. Hopefully more than 3. Two? Hopefully a lot more than 3.
All right. Mr. Fairzone, it is your turn.
Okay. I'm trying to remember how to measure things. Nope. I don't have a straight shot from Thistle. So if Thistle moves up where Sakura and Ajar are, can he take a shot as well, or does he need to move in front of them?
No, he can stand behind them. Okay. You're talking about right here?
Yeah.
Yeah, this thing's very, very large.
Okay. So, dang it. Wrong thing. So he's going to move up there.
Wrong lever!
And I'm going to go ahead and do his attack roll because I was thinking about that first. It's an 18, not a 3.
That's it.
That's a D8 plus dose, I believe, with 10 points of damage.
Thistle for MVP.
Yeah, no kidding.
Right? NPC for MVP.
There's that, and then Fairzon is going to... Well, I should have been counting on my own time, right? But I think I can get there and then move.
Jeez.
That's what the people tune in for, Jay.
Yeah, I know. The counting by fives.
1, 2.
And then... Okay, I can get all the way to... Yeah, I think 6. Yes. Okay. Yeah, 6.
Getting old toasty.
Yeah, he's like hot, trying to get.
So you did provoke an attack of opportunity to get that far.
Okay, I'll take it.
Unless you, well, I don't know. Can he move through the fireball area?
He can. He just can't end his turn there. Okay. Oh no, yeah, he can't. No, he can't move through where
the actual.
Fear is. I think it occupies that space like a creature.
Doesn't
it would be friendly? Doesn't, but that's still difficult terrain.
Oh,
go ahead.
Are you saying? Sorry, were you saying that he provokes from the ogre? Because 5e provoke works different from Pathfinder provoke, right? He's got to actually leave the threatened area of the ogre. Fezzan is a special thing.
You're correct.
Yeah, I was going to say if I need to, I can go Thank between Khaldun.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Actually,
no, you stayed within his reach the entire time.
Yep.
Actually, you know what? Because Fairzon is who he is, he would have interposed himself in between Khaldun and Big Ugly. So Khaldun wouldn't take the brunt of.
It's a party.
Yep.
I was hoping for that.
Fairzon Savage.
Kaldu just places his hands on your waist. Unchained Melody starts playing.
Get The Lobotica. All right. Nice move, Faison.
All right. I think that is going to be it for him. So, these things look big, mean, and nasty, right? I mean, probably pull the shield out, or what do you think?
How about open with the shield?
No. That's my answer.
Yeah. Yeah. He probably would have pulled the shield and flail out just in case again, since there's, you know, he can hear two of them.
So. Can do. All right. No problem.
Make that adjustment on the sheet, and that'll be it.
That means it is Khaldun's turn.
Rock me on my desk. Okay, so Khaldun is going to bop up into this corner.
Now that does provoke.
Okay.
Right? Okay.
Yep.
Whop! Miss. Go ahead.
Yay!
Unless, I don't know, what's your armor class?
17.
Oh, yeah, no, man. No, that's a miss. That's a miss.
And then he's going to like, oh, okay, I see how this is going to go. Hurls a bolt of fire at him.
There's on ducks.
See how this will work. Yeah. Nine.
Nice.
Hit.
Oh.
What?
Fantastic.
Holy crap.
13 points of fire damage.
Fire?
Fire.
All right.
Fire, and fire. Then flamey bouncy ball of happiness is going to roll down here and smash into him. Doot.
Doot. Makes that.
And that's a dexterity.
It's a dex save.
Saving throw. Fail. God. Zombies are slow.
Critical doot.
Critical doot. Critical doot. Yes. 10 points of doot damage.
10 points of doot. Fire damage is now known as doot.
What do you know? He has resistance to doot damage.
Immune to doot.
Doot immunity. All right. That's Khaldun.
Yes, I am. So to redeem himself, he's like, fuck that noise. I'm getting closer. And he's going to take a shot.
All right.
Let's see. One,
Thistle
two,
for MVP right now. So.
Three, four, five, six. Six. Is Ferzon large enough to give this thing cover, or is he still kind of shooting him in the nose? Okay.
No, the ogre's got about 2.5-3 feet over him. It's a big boy.
Yeah. Big on someone your own size.
If I move a jar here, will that be within the ogre's reach?
No, its reach is 10 feet. So okay. Right behind Ferzon.
So I'm going to move him around here. To clear some space for the other bow wielding friends. And he's going to take a shot.
Okay.
Ooh.
Critical.
Natural. Natural.
A 2 and a 0.
Speaking of redemption.
Yes.
Yeah.
Or what a redemption.
Got a new MVP on the block.
A whole 6 plus whatever.
2. So you rolled 2 dice, right?
I did. A 2 and a 4.
Okay. Still, it does some damage, you know. Doesn't have to be maximum every time you get a crit, but a jar is a jar to Khaldun. Oh, that's adjacent. Never mind. Khaldun and a jar. That's it? Yes?
That's it. Yep, we're done.
Pazel. Awesome.
Okay, so Pazel is a little freaking out about the zombies, so she's going to fly around like right there and just stay put.
Keep out. Keep an eye out.
Yep.
All right.
Comes flapping back in. Caca, caca.
It is Ogier's turn. And he's going to take one attack. Yeah, just one attack. With his massive Morning Star against Ferzon.
That's not very nice.
Alliteration is so inappropriate.
That one might hit. Let's see. 23.
It hits exactly.
Your armor class is 23?
With the shield.
What have I done? All right. Let's see. Ooh, God.
All right. Son, por qué?
Not awful, but let's see. Let me do this. Oh, that did bad things. 15 points of damage from the massive Morning Star. It only gets one attack. This other one can't move through it. Actually, you know what? It sure can. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 40. It moves through there. Does that... Farazan, you don't have a... Farazan, does that provoke?
No. No? Okay. Yes. I think.
How? How? How's it provoke?
Even Sentinel? Though you don't have a pole arm, it still walk right beside you.
Yes. Sentinel, it I can... walk right beside as you. Soon as it...
enters your range.
Yeah. He's special.
Yes. So that will be weird, because it actually enters your range when it's moving through its friend's space.
Will it stop him?
It will reduce his speed to 0.
If it hits, if that happens, then I'll just move him back. Like, he hits him back enough, because it's trying to squeeze through it. It knocks him backwards. So that's okay. We can do that way. So currently, right. Basically, right on top of him. So yeah, right, Shmear.
Yeah. Okay.
So you get your AAOE PG.
22.
That's a hit. So I will push him back.
Back to hell.
Yeah.
Matt, did the ogre that crushed for Zahn, he did move out of the flamey boy's space, right? So I think he needs to make a save.
Okay.
Or fire.
Yeah. Yes, you're correct. How much damage did that do?
I think it was something on the order of 853.
Or 12.
Or 12. That's fine.
I think it has 854 left.
Dang it.
How much damage? How much damage did you do with your attack of opportunity?
It was 12.
12?
Okay. Oh, you meant me. Sorry. Yes, yeah. That was also 12.
All right. That was the second one. All right, so yes, I will do a dexterity saving throw from the fire. Fail. Go ahead, roll your damage.
Flame on. 11 points of fire.
11 points of
fire. Bake, baby. Right.
It is baking rotten flesh. This place smells awful.
Unless you're into rotten flesh.
You know what? You're right. When you're right. top of round 6, Tarathiel, it's your turn.
I think this is the don't yum someone else's yuck. Is that
yeah, pretty much. Yeah. I mean, if you're if you like Urgothoa, this might smell like a buffet in here.
Good time.
All right, I want to cross in front of a jar here, which might seem slightly insane, but I'm going to use a bonus action to drop the Lieutenant's Guard caltrops. I want to put one here. Yeah. And one here.
Nice. We haven't seen those genius. In a while.
Genius.
And I'm going to toss a psychic dagger at this dude's face.
My guy's wicked smart.
Wicked smart.
Wicked smart.
Oh, my library. There it is.
It'll be a 21 to hit, which, because Fezzan is adjacent, I get my sneak attack. So it's 23 total damage.
Oh, my God.
Bang!
Schlick-schlock.
Yes, you should even see the word bang.
This just turned into a Batman comic book.
Biff, pow.
I knocked you into a different yoga. Form of entertainment. All right. It is messed up, but it's still going.
Well, in that case,
I'm going to make a magic item that does that. That narrates its damage.
Just onomatopoeia damage?
Yes, yes.
A rod of onomatopoeia.
Onomatopoeia. Yes. That's exactly what I was thinking of.
Put it on the DM's guild thing, you make tens of drachma. Alright, Sakura's going to throw an arrow using his bow.
Mike, remind me where you wanted those caltrops.
One here, one here.
In the fire, and then...
In the flames.
Okay. Okay, gotcha.
Ooh, red hot caltrops served up.
Bam, bam. Yeah, just like that, yeah.
Yeah, because I can drop them within 20 feet, so I can just hit there.
Okay, perfect. You did your psychic damage, lots of it, and anything else?
Sakura with the bow.
Okay.
14 to hit.
Hit.
Sakura comes in and plants an arrow in this thing's face for 8 piercing damage.
So, arrow pierces into its neck, and it rears back, almost falling.
On Fezzan. Like,
on Fezzan. How much damage did you do? 8? That would be... But does not fall. It catches itself and turns back towards Fezzan and continues to swing its Morning Star thematically.
I'll get you next time, undead man.
Or next episode. Yeah, man. Let's see. That was Tritheon Sakara. All right, Fezzan, it's your turn.
Oh, yay. Since this guy is still just hanging out in front of me, I'm going to continue on with the shield and flail. All
right.
How about a 16 to hit?
That's a hit.
With minimum damage, 6 points of damage.
6 points of damage. Begins to teeter. It loses a finger. And Tirithiel loses a tear. But it continues to stand.
I see you, buddy.
So Fairzod's going to swing again with the flail, and this time he will say, "Timber." 22 to hit, and a whopping 9 points of damage.
9 points of damage, and it falls. I'm gonna actually take it off. Well, you know what? This guy is difficult terrain for combat. It's a big old dude, so I'm going to leave him there.
Just to confuse the hell out of us.
Yes, and to make things more interesting.
Stinky.
Slash harder.
He's burning and smoldering and stinking. He is
cooking.
We're going to break his smolder.
Kill a taco right now.
All right. I'm trying to think with some strategy here. When does this thing go in the turn order?
When do the zombies go? After Pazel. So it's Tirithiel, Fezzan, Khaldun, Pazel, the ogres.
Okay. So Fezzan will say to Khaldun. Sorry. One more time. The order.
Tirithiel, Fezzan, Khaldun, Pazel.
Okay. So Fezzan will tell Khaldun, says, "I'm going to take a step back. Can you move the fire so that it blocks the entire area, the entire passage?" So I'm going to move Fezzan here, I believe. And then if you can bring the fireball down one, I think I can keep him in there with hitting it. So he's going to switch back to Fairzone's going to switch back to his long staff pole arm. So that he can, so he can have an extra reach and keep him in that fire.
Sure.
So he's
gonna honestly, if you did not have inspiration, I would give it to you because that is a brilliant tactical move.
Why? Thank you.
Very good.
Let me go ahead and have Thistle move. 6.
We're gonna have ourselves a good old fashioned reach off, people.
Yep.
Yeah.
Thistle's
This is PG, dude.
Is it?
Was PG.
Thistle's gonna take a shot with a longbow.
You're happily correct. Was PG.
AC 15, 13.
That's it.
Excellent. Gotta just keep pushing forward. 9 points from an arrow to the other eye.
Got it.
Okay. And that'll be it. Me.
All right. Khaldun, it is your turn.
Alrighty. I am going to hurl some flame at the standing ogre. Can we see behind the ogre? Is there another one? Is there a third one back there?
You don't see anything else. There's not a third one. No.
Alrighty. Hurling flame incoming. 10. Why'd I roll it? That's an 18 to hit.
Oh, that's a hit. That's it.
Firebolt for a whopping massive snake eyes.
Ouch.
It's a micro. Ooh,
seriously?
Micro dude.
2 points of 2 points of damage.
Beat my friend, mini dude.
Yes. Yes.
Right, 2 points of damage on 2d10. That's rare.
That's bad.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. anything else?
I would not describe it that way. And I am going to move Flamey Dude, like we discussed.
All right.
Right there.
All right. I'm moving the body out of the way for clarity. But sure. It's still there. Right. So it doesn't. You're not charged. Okay. Yeah.
I'm not going to charge because if I charge it, it has to stop.
Gotcha.
So I'm not going to do that.
All right.
And then a jar is going to take a shot.
All right.
17.
Hit.
Hooray.
38. No. Sorry.
Yes.
No.
Yes, please roll the d20 for damage.
Wrong thing. Oh, well, 8 points of damage.
Nice.
Plus
total four. Of 10. All right.
He's like, dude, I got a 20, and then I got a full 8. I'm like,
he's rocking.
Shut up and shoot.
Yeah, we are done.
All right. That was Khaldun. Pazel hanging out?
Yeah, she's going to hang out.
All right. Ogre steps forward, and we'll attack Farazan.
Get my opportunity attack before it.
All right.
Can get too close, right?
You hit it when it gets in your area, so you won't knock it back. You'll stop it right there. So it'll still get to attack you.
That's fine. As long as I can stop it in the fire.
You do get your attack of opportunity.
Okay. 16 to hit.
That's a hit.
Excellent.
Heath, do I need to do anything entering the heat, or is it only... How's it work?
Only if it ends its turn.
Ends its turn, okay.
And it now has a speed of 0 and takes 11 points of damage.
11? Good lord. All right. It's still kicking, but you just now managed to bloody it. And it will reach out and touch a Goliath tomorrow.
Oh,
what? Right. It's turn. Top of
natural
round
ones, folks. Second. Natural ones.
Yes, for those listening and not viewing, natural one. Top of round 7, Tarathiel, it is your turn.
Save or bake.
Oh, saving throw? Got it.
Save or bake.
Oh, that's probably still... No, that's a fail. It's got a negative dexterity saving throw. Yes, I take damage.
Okay, have some damage.
Ooh.
16 points of dude.
You made up for it, for sure. Double duted.
That's maximum dutage.
Dude combo! Alright, Tarathiel, your turn.
Alright, Tarathiel is going to take a moment, take aim, and throw a psychic dagger over Fezzan's shoulder, through the fire, and into this thing's throat.
Dutality.
You know, where the brain is.
Alright.
That's a 25 to hit for
that's
22
a hit.
Total damage.
That's a lot of damage. And it is teetering, but still going.
All right. Let's see if we can give Sakura the kill. Sakura's going to cross over behind Fezzan and fire an arrow for 8.
8 to hit?
8. Yes.
That is a hit.
Holy cow.
Really?
These things are huge.
Holy ogre, I guess.
Right on the nose. This thing has an 8 armor class.
Slow and massive.
Yes.
Hey,
there's a big bucket of hit points.
6 piercing damage.
6 points of damage. And with that shot, as before, as all these other creatures, it stumbles for a moment, but regains its composure and continues to stand.
Yes, it has orcish ferocity.
It has. All right, I'm done. Zombiness.
Yeah.
That was
zombitudinous fortitude.
Imagine, can you imagine a zombie Tarrasque? You would never kill that.
Stop.
Yeah.
Stop.
Like ever.
Well, that's the next room. Don't worry.
No.
Stupid no.
No. Fairzon is going to poke at it with a stick. 18 is going to hit for 9.
All right. And again, as we've seen over and over, it continues to stand.
Oh my gosh.
Whack it. Like a Babe Ruth it, but it's still...
It's a pinata.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he's going to use the other end of the stick. Another 18.
Hit.
How about some more damage? Nope. How about less damage? Seven. Singular.
Seven, however, is enough, and it does fall heavily to the ground, defeated before the onslaught of Yuns.
Yuns.
And dudes.
Well. Okay.
So that is Fairzon's turn. Your ball of fire, I think, has another round left.
Okay.
Did you cast it on first round or second round?
Second round.
Okay. So it's got, yeah, after this round, it'll have one more round of whatever duration.
Oh, wait. Once that passes. No, I'm sorry. It was the first round. It was the first round because I did it around the corner.
Oh, well, this will be around. Oh, no, it's got two more. It's got 10 rounds total.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I just want to give you full use of it. Cool. As soon as this spell expires, we'll get out of combat turns, but you see how close everything is. So I didn't want to take that away from you.
I appreciate it.
All right. Fairzon, you just mortified it, right? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Thistle.
Fairzon's going to take a move action.
Okay.
And he is going to take a quick step down hill. So.
Ka-chung, 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 running on down the hallway. You're using the
torch. Stop doing that.
Let's see.
Well, he's not going to go around the corner, but like he's going to like step on the other side of those things just in case something else comes around the corner.
Well, right. He's the brood squad, so it doesn't matter.
So you are also you're carrying the torch, the continual flame torch. Is that right?
Yep. Okay.
Yep. That's 60 feet, right?
No, 40. I think it's only 40.
Is that 40 as well? All right. Just make sure I get my distances right. And you open up said room. There we go.
The sound effects
I've got to do something for the listeners while I'm like clicking, these awful polygonal reveal buttons. See,
this is why we need onomatopoeia. You need a.
Grisplaco.
Ka-chow.
There you go. That is 40 feet.
Okay. I mean, I can do some of that. I can, you know.
You can see up here, too.
All right. And Fairzon's going to stay there.
Thistle.
Thistle is going to follow behind, just kind of creeping up behind him. He's not going to run, so he's going to move up there.
Single action. Okay. Khaldun, it's your turn.
Okay, I'm going to measure something real quick and see if I can get the ball around the corner without baking for Zahn.
All right.
1, 2, 3, hot. 4... Hot. 5.
That's a hot,
colder. You're going to have to move. You're going to have to pass through Fairzon. That's a wall that you just skipped through. You see that wall?
Oh, you're right. Oh, I didn't.
That's a wall.
Okay, let me go
back. That's a wall right there.
All right. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can I go diagonally? 5?
I believe so.
6?
There you go. Yeah, that'll work.
Okay.
That'll work.
So scoot, little dude. Right. And
he's a torch as well, right?
Yeah, he's basically a torch, yes.
All right. So let's continue on with the expanding of light. out to 40 feet. It makes me click on it twice every single time. I don't get it.
How dare it?
You don't see anything else. I'm just opening up some more space.
Doom.
It continues on south, but you also can tell that there's a southeasterly passage going the other way.
Going southeasterly.
Do you see what I'm saying? I fumbled my words, but
I don't think you can actually see saying. Okay,
Matt's making a word salad. You take all the words and then you adjust them.
This, I'm pinging the other passageway.
Okay,
got it. Okay, that's all understandable. Right. You showed me. All right, so I am going to
say the words coming out of my mouth.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12. So dash action.
Move in a dash.
Yes. And I am done moving.
And you've got light, but you're behind the
it's
fireball.
A torch. All right. It's a torch, yeah.
Okay. Khadun, Ajar.
Oh, Ajar, he's gonna bop along as well. 1, 2, 3.
Hazel still gonna
4,
hang out.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, Pazella, she's going to stay put. She's going to hold station.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Next round, Tarathiel. We're back to you again. There'll be one more round after this of the bouncing fireball thing.
Okay.
11, 12. All right, bonus action. I'll retrieve the caltrops, and then I will follow my companions.
Done.
30 gets me to there. Dash. 15. I will move to there.
And you have dark vision.
Yeah, I usually got 60.
To 60 feet, yeah.
Da, da, da. All right. Got some more stuff.
I should have an aura on. For my you do. 60 I keep feet, forgetting so you can that. See the edges.
Yeah. Very handy. I like that.
Very nice aura.
So that is what you see now. And let me clarify this a little bit. That's stone. Some stone walls there.
Changes everything.
That's a nice aura. I like that aura. All right. Sakura will come down as well.
He can probably see down that southeast passage too.
Oh, good call. Let's
open Sakura will just come down to there. I'm kind of playing these guys. I'm playing Sakura, and I think we're all playing them as like they don't want to die. they want to get paid. So they're in a supporting role. They're never going to be the guys out front.
And complete honesty, if you did something that would be suicidal or absolutely out of the character, I would stop you. Be like, he's not going to headbutt the Tarrasque. Yeah. I don't care how many gold pieces you give him. All right, so you look down here, and it goes beyond your vision, but it's a large cavern to the southeast. Khaldun, you and yours.
Okay. I'm going to leave the ball of flame. So I'm going to move Flamey there. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Through the wall?
5. No. 5. Oh. 6.
It won't matter, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We haven't seen anything to ram with it, so.
Yeah. So he should be shedding a little more light there, I think. 40 feet. Yep.
40 feet?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, open this up to here. It does reveal a bit more, but
reveal.
It's a larger area of the cavern that you've already seen.
So we've already been here.
That Tarathiel could see. You just extend that a bit further.
Oh, got it. I was panicking a little, just a little.
Wait, we're going in circles and it's dark.
Okay, and so Khaldun is going to follow a little happy ball of flame. One, two, three, four, five, six.
I call him Bernie.
Yeah.
had a fun weekend at his place.
It could be Bernice.
Two, three, four, five, six.
And can I see any more? It's 40.
So I'm checking. 40 feet. So you come down around the corner.
Why is it always me?
Because you charge forward like brave human.
The rest of the party is like, why does he keep doing that? You know, because we have Giga stealth. Why does he keep doing that?
So it's interesting. Where you're standing now is exactly the aura that Tarathiel. So that's making it very easy for me to reveal your doom.
Oh, let's see. Good.
Welcome to your doom.
You step around.
Ah, that is not good at all.
A creature that's been standing there somewhat.
For 5 days.
Stoically? Like it was just standing there. Walk the dog for 5 days. You see it standing there. It looks like at one point it had been chained. This, and see this block right behind it? That is a large stone coffer. Like chest, like a coffer. Oh. And you can see that this creature at one point had been chained to this coffer. But those chains have broken away. Yeah, it looks like it's ripped the chains off over time. You see the creature. It looks obviously undead. If you can't tell by the token, let me blow this up a little bit.
I don't want you to.
Oh, you can't see the creature. You can't see the creature, can you?
Please no.
Oh no. Oh no.
Please no.
Can we get a close up?
Don't do it.
Has anyone seen Batman?
Saw the latest one.
I liked it.
That's helpful. That's the same size.
It's right, got so, things in its eyes. It's got things for eyes. This is not good.
So what you see essentially is obviously a zombie of some sort, but it's obviously a dwarven zombie, right?
Oh no!
In life, it was a dwarf. And worse. Those things that you see in its eyes aren't just in its eyes. You see green, wriggly worms in its eyes. You see them dripping out of its mouth, crawling in and under and around its skin.
It's a worm zombie.
And as you come around and you shed the light, it snaps. Like these other zombies have been kind of slow moving. This thing whips its head around at you.
And it keeps
going.
You
need to roll. And you need to. We're going to reroll initiative because your ball is done, right? That's why we've been doing this. This is intro of a new character, a new creature.
Time to take your ball and go home.
It's definitely going to go home.
Yeah, we're going to reroll initiative at this point.
Okay.
Because if it goes right now, you won't be happy.
Well, I have a thing.
So
let's do this.
I'm actually going to do something. These things are pretty horrifying.
Initiatory.
You think?
Bye, bouncy ball of flame.
Nope. That does not help.
That's the same
size. Yeah, I tried to enlarge it, but it didn't enlarge what you guys see. All right.
Is this one of those really terrible
Yes.
from the Fiend Folio?
It looks terrible to you.
Does it have anybody like Fiend Folio, like written, like, you know?
Does anybody have above a 20? I'm not going to tell you what it is.
I have 12.
Shut up.
Oh, hey. Pazel's got a 20.
Pazel has a 20. Anybody 15 to 20 at all? No. All right. 10 to 15.
Mm-hmm. All of us.
Okay, give me some numbers.
12.
All right. 12. Who's going first? You or Khaldun?
Khaldun.
All right. And Tarathiel, you got what, a 2?
10.
10, all right.
Can't roll initiative for some reason.
I think we were better before.
I know, that's why I assumed it was a 2. All right. Pazel, you have initiative.
Well, she's kind of going to hang out and watch out for the zombies from the rear.
She's going to watch the idiots that have run forward to meet this undead, whatever it is.
So, the creature goes next, and it's looking at you, and all it does is bring its arm back and sling it towards you. And dozens of those worms fly out towards you.
Oh, I hate worms.
Worm vision. Jeez. Yikes.
Worms.
It's a worm that works.
Give it's me...
Cone of worms.
Give me a dexterity saving throw.
Just Khaldun?
Yeah, he's the only one in range. Okay. And the worms land just... The ones that don't actually hit him land about 5 feet behind him.
So it's a hose of worms. Nice. Yeah. Here comes the dex. Oh, holy cow.
21.
Nice.
All right. So the worms hit you, and they're crawling along your skin.
I'm offended.
And they start to burrow into your skin. But the dexterity save is you wiping them off before they can get under your skin and start digging into your flesh. Yeah.
Dude, I am flailing.
I hate this. And about that time, a second one comes out from my
PC.
And does the same thing.
Joy.
Give me another dexterity saving throw.
You have initiative. Inspiration.
Oh, thank you. Oh, can I give him, if I didn't need it, I would give it to him. I'm going to use it. Thank you very much.
There
you go. I'm going to use my inspiration.
My brain panicked and was like, you have I word. The thing.
The thing that makes it do better. Icky. Inchworm.
Oh my gosh. 11. I rolled a 5 and a 9, yes.
Oh, it didn't pop up on the feed.
Yeah, for some reason I did it when I used roll or D&D Beyond to do the advantage, it rolled like the digital dice, but for some reason it didn't go across.
Weird.
Yeah. So 11 with advantage. I got a feeling that that's not good.
You are sitting there and you're wiping as many off as you can, and several of them start burrowing into your arms.
I love this.
I don't.
Khaldun, it's your turn. So let me give you some options. Okay. You can attempt to stab and dig at these worms as an action.
I'm going to have nightmares.
Because they're under your skin. They're digging, they're burrowing. You're going to be cutting into your arms to kill these things or to dig them out and plop them on the ground.
Nope. Okay. All right.
So that's your option to deal with these worms that are burrowing and they're traveling up your arm under your skin.
Okay.
Your turn.
You said options is plural. That's like one.
Well, you also can cast spells or run up and attack with your staff. I'm telling you, that's how you can deal with the worms that are burrowing in your skin.
Death is an option.
It is. Can I burn them?
Let me just read real quick.
So cutting them out is the only option, or is it like just damaging them? You see what I'm saying?
Tourniquet?
Yeah, let me just... It's under your skin.
Under your skin. Life is better. Down there, sweater. Under your skin.
No, I'm going to say you're going to have to dig it out. What you're doing is you're digging this thing out of your arm. So fire would burn but...
Yeah, I just had visions of Khaldun turning the gnomish hot rod on his own arm.
Yes, I'm blowtorching these suckers.
Oh.
Geyser. No, you're going to need to use some sort of piercing or edge weapon. Slicing or piercing. Okay. Slashing or piercing.
I just imagine using a mace to get... Actually, it might work. It would crush them.
Yeah, you might squish them. Inside their bodies.
Okie dokie.
You guys have to sleep after this.
Nope. Nope.
All right, so I'm going to ask a kind of a weird question. Can I get a sense for how far this worm spew can go?
They're the ones that missed you landed right behind you.
Okay, so I'm roughly at range for this, whatever it is.
You're right at the edge.
Okay. I'm moving away from right at the edge.
Well, okay, let me clarify. You're right at the edge of the first one. The second one is 5 feet closer. See what I'm saying?
Yep.
Okay.
I understand. Terribly.
I bring it back here.
That's what I don't want.
Keep all the yuck up there. I've now regretted making a melee-only character.
I've never regretted making a character.
Saying yes when Matt sent me a message.
I'm going to move the flamey ball of happiness over here because he's not there anymore.
Okay. Expire the
spell. Yeah. All right. Yep. Jeez. Yep. And I'm casting fireball.
Mm-hmm.
Dropping it right between them.
Thank you.
Dexterity save.
DC 16,
please. What do they got? Oh, not very good. So, the first one, the one that's closest to you, fail. The one that's not natural 20. So, 23 and what, 11?
Yes.
Ooh, okay.
That's a lot of ones.
If there's anything else in the room.
Yeah, gotcha. So 23 and 11. Let me make sure they're not resistant to fire. Probably not. Most dead things aren't. All right. Fireball goes off, explodes in a explosion. And they're still up. They're singed. One obviously worse than the other, but they are still up.
Okay. And then I am going to go... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 down here.
All right.
And then a Jar is going to take a shot at the one that he can see.
Where is Jar? He's the top one. Okay.
Yeah, no problem.
Have him step aside 5 feet, 10 feet. Oh, because he's got two people in front of him.
Natural 20.
That doesn't matter. Okay. Natural 20 on the one in the front. Roll some damage.
All of it.
5. That's amazing.
That was a different four-letter word. Are you adding plus 2?
I'm not even
looking. No, I'm not. That's just the dice. So 7 total.
7 total. Okay. All right. Thunk into it. And you see where the arrow hits. It gashes. The arrow falls out and worms just drain out of the wound.
Yeah. Yum. So he's you know what? I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna do an intelligence check for him.
Okay.
And he failed. So he's gonna stay where he is.
All right. So talk to me about what you were thinking for him.
Well, any intelligent person would see a hose of worms and think, you know what? I shouldn't be stacked up like this because a hose of worms is gonna get all of us and move away.
So it's a cone versus a hose, just FYI. I mean, it's important. It's not a stream. It is a
So we're just screwed either way.
God.
Easy.
It's burning hands formation, not lightning bolt formation.
Yes, correct. But it is a big old cone.
It's worming hands.
Yes, worming hands. All right, so fair enough. You know, he's going to hang out. Anything else from the two of you? I think that's it. Farzan, it's your turn.
I don't want it to be.
You skip Tarethiel. No, I'm joking.
I don't know. This is going to be... Ugh.
I feel like you do know.
There's no charge action, right?
It's called dash. No.
Yeah,
it's just dash.
It's called move and attack. Yeah.
Move and attack.
Actually, I think there's a feat called charger, but it is utter crap.
Yeah, and I don't think it gives you extra movement. I think it just, like, adds some damage to your attack or something.
Okay.
I can judge. I'm not gonna.
Farazan is going to move on the diagonal over to here. That's 20 feet, and then 10 more feet to... I think... Does that give him any cover at all?
From a ranged attack?
Yes.
Yes, but you are in line of sight for something that would cause a saving throw. Does that make sense? Like, if it had to roll to hit, you have cover. If you have to make a saving throw, it doesn't do any good at all. So the worms can hit you, if that's your question. Yeah. From this one, only the front one. If you were here, yes.
Okay.
But right here, it can still corner to corner.
Okay. Okay. That's fine.
Okay.
That's fine. I think that's fine. Okay. I think that's fine. All right. So, hand axes. He's going to pull out throwy.
So, like I said, you have cover from two hits. So does it.
Okay. So, the me being close to cover and it being further away from cover doesn't, like, you know, okay.
It's not like a wall, like a waste wall.
Okay.
You know, you're throwing around a wall, so no, okay. Not in this particular point.
All right, that's fine. That'll be a 17. So whatever plus it has, we'll go for that.
A 17 to hit. That's a hit.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Okay. That will be an 8. And then he will pull Choppy out.
Is that Choppy or Throw?
That was Throw. Throw is first. Right. Choppy is second. So he looks at Choppy and says, "Alas, I knew you will." And he will throw Choppy for a 21.
That's a hit.
And another 8 points of damage.
Got it.
And with the bonus action, he is going to shudder violently. Exactly.
Full body shiver.
Exactly that. And with gonna throw a dagger, because this counts as two weapon fighting, throwing things, yes.
Yes, you've thrown two weapons already.
Okay, so he's going to pull a dagger, and if I can find where I
put... Oh yeah, you got multiple attacks. That's right.
Yep. For a bonus action, a dagger is going to be a 23.
That's a hit.
Thrown for 7 points of damage.
This is where Farazan just starts picking stuff off the ground.
It's Triel all over again.
Yeah, like, exactly. Rolled
everything but the kitchen sink that fight.
Bedroll.
Plank skin.
Yeah.
I just think it's hilarious. Like, you're like, I am not getting near this thing. I refuse to. It is writhing.
He's like, ooh, ooh, ooh. Just
thrust it. Like doing like patty cakes. Yeah, ah.
Exactly.
Alright, what about your dude?
Thistle, is that what? Oh, he's got a longbow, so he's just gonna unload on it from there.
Alright.
Which is one of these. Nope. It's a D20 plus 4, right?
Correct.
Plus 4, with a 10. It's probably a little low.
10 is a hit.
Oh, wow, okay. With a D8 plus 2, with 9 points of damage. He did more damage with an arrow than Farazan did with any of his three things. So, good job, the thistle.
Longbows are deadly.
Yeah. All right. He's going to move forward just a touch to hug this wall.
So he's got some cover.
Yep. That's it.
Anything else? Tarathiel, it's your turn.
All right. Tarathiel's going to move forward 15 feet and then toss the lieutenant's guard again. One there. One there.
Here and here. Correct?
No, there.
Nope. Right here.
Yep.
Alright. Right here.
Blocking off the passage. He's gonna throw a psychic dagger into this one's face.
Alright.
That's the noise I make. 11 to hit probably doesn't hit.
That is a hit.
Yay.
It is a hit. All right,
that's it. Cool.
Well, now we'll do 5 psychic damage because natural ones.
Oh boy.
And then
psychic damage. All right.
He's and then the remainder of his 15 feet of movement, he will nope off into the corner.
Alright. And your dude?
He will just take a shot at this one from where he is. Ooh, 10 to hit.
Hit.
Oh, dang. And these things aren't big.
Interesting.
Four, three, again. Three, count them. 3 points of damage.
3 whole points of damage.
Then I guess he will move to there, because I think it gives him a cleaner shot down the passage, and also moves him even slightly further away.
All right. That is round one. Top of round two.
Round one of the last combat of Fezzan's life.
Hazel is the start of round two.
Oh, good. Anything she different? Is going to eat. She's, No, I think she's going to stay right there.
No.
All right. So remind me how.
Oh, Caltrum's wait, you know what? I take that back. I'm sorry.
She is.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's one move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This square's a little wonky here. 6.
Scaring the crud of Sakura and Thistle as she flies between them out of the darkness.
Yeah, she just like zings.
She would be deadly silent.
That's funny.
That's a double move.
Now deliver this necklace of fireballs to the enemies.
All of it.
To whom it may concern.
Make sure you understood me. Use all the balls.
I'm concerned
not
that
a
you
lot
heard.
Of them.
I want a lot yes. of fireball. What I said was deliver all the fireball
all
you
the
have.
All the fireball.
Yeah, she's gonna. She's actually. She's gonna stop back there.
All right. So, Caltrips. They're difficult terrain. It hits it. It has to make a dexterity saving throw.
Yeah, DC 15 dex saving throw, or you stop and you take piercing damage and it reduces your speed by 10 feet until you heal at least one hit point.
All right. So first thing.
Important point, because it might make a difference. A creature moving through the area at half speed doesn't need to make the save.
Mm-hmm. Okay. They're unintelligent. They're hauling ass.
Hauling ants as well as worms?
Worms.
Jeez, what is going on in here?
Fairzon really is the only person that's close enough to notice that some of the wounds that have been inflicted on these things are closing. They have healed. The one that was burned doesn't look like it was ever even touched. The one that saved, made saving throw, does not look like it had been touched by the fire. And the first one, it doesn't move like a normal zombie. Like, it is running, it's like 37 days later kind of zombie. Like, it is just running full tilt, screaming. Worms are just falling off of it, trailing. It's like leaving a slug trail of worms behind it.
Yummy.
It does hit the Caltrum, so it needs to make, you said, a DC 15 dexterity 15. Saving throw. 15.
Yep.
Or else it stops.
Yes, it stops and takes 1 piercing damage.
Okay.
And reduces its walking speed, but we'll see what happens.
It fails.
Yay.
Hey!
So that movement stops. It does take a point of damage. That's the front one.
I think that's as far as it can go.
Well, it can dash.
No.
But it doesn't. Instead,
Wrong.
It slings its arms out.
No, please dash. Please dash.
Give me a dexterity saving throw, Fairzon only.
It slings its arms out? Like
so it's
Beetlejuice arms?
it's slinging worms out of its hands and off its arms. Oh. And like it's slinging. Okay. You see what I'm saying? Like it's just, these things are just dripping and crawling all over it.
Imagine it's got like a heavy open sleeve and worms just pour out of it like a fire hose. Yeah.
And Tarathiel, you are blocked by the terrain. So only Farzan. Dexterity saving throw.
I'm going to spend inspiration to give this advantage.
Okay.
Spend it, I think.
And I just since I have the floor here, I was noting that they changed the Goliath thing from the thing that gives him proficiency in athletics and extra weight that he can carry. Instead of natural athlete, it's now called little giant.
Oh,
so, yeah, I thought that was cute.
It's adorable.
Huh. Don't let the name fool you. In real life, he's really big.
Natural 20.
So, just like when Khaldun was hit, but he made saving throw, the worms are all over you, but you are just wiping them off. They hit your armor and they bounce off, but essentially, they don't. None of them land on you, or the ones that do, you knock off quickly. So you make your saving throw, and no effect.
Farzan is regretting his decision to take the arms off of the armor, so that his you know, he's got extra mobility in his arms.
Yeah, you just want to be cool and cut your sleeves off.
You're right.
The second one runs up, hits the caltrops, and fails.
Yes!
Taking a point of damage.
I'm so happy with this.
Me too. Me too.
And it follows suit. It slings worms at Farzan. Give me a dexterity saving throw.
It's putting spin on him like in Wanted.
Yeah. Is it going around?
Getting the worms to go around the wall.
Do I get a bonus or like anything for the wall?
It's a saving throw.
Okay.
Let me see. Is it full cover? Because it's corner to corner, right?
I don't know. You tell me.
Yeah. It can hit you. It's your target, essentially. Okay.
Dang it.
And they're coming out in a cone like this. Right, but cone spiraling is coming out to here. Like this whole corridor, there are just dozens of green worms just writhing and crawling over the floor.
So these creatures are actually like carrying the portal to like one of the 763rd layer of planes the abyss. We're just
planes of gross.
Yes, these are actually mobile portals of filth.
A plane of worms.
Yes.
Instead of trying to dodge, Farzan just reaches up on the helmet of the plate mail and just closes the visor.
And right as you get the last inch, one just gets in and you close it inside with your visor.
Hey. Oh, no.
And we got the Wrath of Khan as it goes up your face and crushes the crawl out of your ear.
Dang it. I'm going to have that dream again tonight.
That haunts me. That film.
Yeah, that got me as a kid. That freaked me out. All right, six.
Yes.
You do not get rid of all the worms crawling. Unfortunately, because you have sleeveless armor now, one of them hits you in the shoulder or in the arm, and you do not get it in time, and it starts to burrow into your under your skin and up your starts moving up your arm.
Yep.
That is it for them. It is now Khaldun's turn. So, at the beginning of your turn, Khaldun, you immediately take some damage from the worms. You take 7 points of necrotic damage. And you feel the worms, they're up around your shoulder now. They're crawling up.
That's fantastic.
Do not like.
You said, I'm sorry, you said seven? Seven? Okay.
7 points, yes. Necrotic damage.
5, 6, 7. Okay.
How about right. like can we take a potion? You think like drinking a potion?
Just push them out like a Wolverine pushing out a bullet.
Like an antifungal? A dewormer?
Matt, you said that they basically seem to be healing the fire damage or immune to the fire damage or something like that?
No, they're regenerating.
Okay. All right. So it's They don't seem to be immune to it. They're just healing.
No, the damage is just healing.
Got it.
They were damaged by your fireball and all that good stuff. Everybody's been damaged. It's just those wounds. It's like the worms are like knitting them up, or the mucus from the worms is gooey and it kind of holds the wounds together, but they're healing as you watch them.
Not helping.
Damn you, worms. Okay.
We have to take a shower.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, so I am looking through my pockets for anything that can just annihilate these kinds of creatures, and I don't have anything like that, so I'm going to cast a spell.
Okay. You don't have any daggers or anything?
Daggers? Oh, yeah, sharp I've got objects. A dagger. Yeah, yeah, oh, I, okay. I got a, okay, okay. I got a sharp object. And I have harsh language.
You have really harsh language.
Rasp-like tongue.
Yeah, I know I need to get to these worms, but I also need to kill these things. So it's I'm like trading, you know, how long can I live with worms in me and do damage? Let's see here. One, two, three, four. Okay, so from right here, I can see behind the zombies, yes, right?
Absolutely.
I
can? Yeah, oh yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep.
So I'm gonna cast Flaming Sphere behind the zombies.
Okay.
So I can drop it. Where'd my little friend go?
I moved him off the. You can't see. I'll get him back to you.
You are so evil.
Open some more up, and there he is.
Okay. Thank you. So I'll drop him right there. And then as a bonus action, roll his little happy butt right there and smash it. Can I tell which one is worse off?
The one on the right is much worse off. The one on the left barely has. The only damage it's got is a caltrop sticking his toe.
Okay. All right. So, yeah, I'll bump into the one that's worse off.
Okay. Put you right there then.
Yep. So
that's a dexterity saving throw, right?
It is.
Fail. Man, I am rolling crap tonight when it's going to saving throw. It's amazing.
So rolling poops.
5 points of flamey damage to the one I pooped.
Dude.
Burned and burned.
And then I'm going to use my remaining two squares of movement to peace out. Ness. And I'm. And then the jar is going to take a shot. That's also take a shot at the one that is harmed.
Same one.
Yeah. Okay. 15.
Hit.
9 points of pointy damage.
Got it. 16. Okay.
Sharpened pencil damage.
And after he's seen the worm vomit, he's like, "No, no, 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 no! I'm gonna move."
Yeah, because those worms are land. So if he moves forward, he's starting to get right next to where the last.
Okay, no, he's gonna go like
yeah,
here.
Right, yeah. So I'm gonna interject and say he is not happy with going forward.
Yeah, I'm trying to move him someplace safer.
Safer. Okay.
Yeah.
Let me just see.
Less quick. Wormy.
Yes, much less wormy. Yeah.
So this line right here is where they come out to.
Don't cross that line.
Yeah. This whole area is just writhing.
Well, they can move now. They just had to end their movement when they hit the caltrops.
Sure. No, it's not their turn yet. I'm just saying like, this whole area has just got worms crawling all over it.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, that gross. Was Caladoon. Farzan, it is your turn. So, first thing, you take some damage. Mm-hmm. You take... to, what is that, 8 points of necrotic damage, and you feel the worms crawling, burrowing.
Yep, got it.
That's what the damage is, of your skin towards your elbow. Yep,
got it.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Got it. Yep.
Understood. Shut up. I have to sleep tonight.
I do.
You don't have to.
Okay. All right. So, in my estimation here, Are more worms going to be worse than some worms?
No, it depends on
reach worm saturation.
Yes.
Right. You're not sure. You're asking whether or not it's if you get hit by more worms, will it be bad or worse?
Yes.
You don't know. It's something that give me a. Insight. You know what? I'll give you a chance.
Perception.
More like a knowledge.
Survival.
Nature me.
Roll me an intelligence check. How about that? Just if. Do you have any knowledge skills? Are you okay? Give me just a straight up intelligence check.
I mean, the only knowledge-ish thing that he would have would be survival. So I'm gonna roll a intelligence.
Yeah.
12.
12. All right. 12's not awful.
Thanks.
Well, it's not. So, what you feel like is these things are crawling up, right? Mm-hmm. And you can see them crawling under you can see them writhing under Khaldun's skin, moving up.
Yep.
And they're moving up, and as we're talking, like, they're coming up his neck, right? Uh-huh. So it looks like they're crawling towards the brain.
Right.
And whether or not you get more down here, these are going to get you there first.
Okay.
Right? So mechanics-wise, the damage will not increase, but you'll have an additional one to deal with, right?
Okay.
Okay.
All right. So given that, what would it take to cut these things out?
A sharp piercing or slashing weapon and cutting it out of your body.
An action?
Attacking yourself. Yes. Yes, an action. Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. So if I taking the attack action, would I get two attacks still?
Sure. Yeah.
Murder myself.
Yeah, absolutely.
One to take care of him, and then one to hit the other thing.
Sure.
Okay.
Just don't throw your last edge weapon.
Right. Now he's got a few.
You pull a spear out. You're like.
great sword.
Yeah. Flip it over like carving.
Yeah.
All right.
So pull out a dagger.
What?
And the first attack, quote unquote, I guess, is going to be against himself.
Okay, so you're attacking the worm.
Yeah, attacking the worm.
Roll the hit.
I don't want to. 12? 9? Well, hold on. Can't tell what that's actually supposed to be. Okay, 9.
9? Alright, so you. It's not a hard difficulty. You jab into your arm and you cut and you slice the worm falls out. It's dead. But you take 1 point of damage from cutting it out.
Okay.
Objection. That sounds very difficult.
I think it's more difficult mentally, not actually stabbing. You know, like,
the manual dexterity required is simple.
Cut off your own thumb or something. Like, I could do it. I just don't want to. So, yeah, you have stopped the worm from crawling under your skin towards your brain.
Okay.
Thanks.
So, that's one attack.
Uh-huh.
All right. So he will take the dagger and put it in his teeth because he knows he's going to use it again. And then with the long...
It's got worm guts all over it. Yeah. It tastes terrible. Yep. Give me Constitution 7 throw.
No. And he will take a step forward. Where's my step forward? To here. Nope.
I moved you for it.
Okay. I was like, He bamfed. And he's going to start swinging with his long staff. 10.
So. Okay. Yep. 10 hits.
Okay.
Which one are you attacking?
The one that. Okay, I've lost track of which one was which, but the one that's most damaged.
The hurt one. Okay.
Yeah.
That's fine.
That's
the one on the right.
So I'm also going to expend a superiority die to trip attack this thing.
All right. Talk to me about trip attack.
It has to make a DC 15 strength saving throw.
Succeed.
Oh, dang. Okay. But I do get to add my D8 superiority die to the damage.
Right.
So I get 7 from the attack and then 3 more from the trip attack. So that's 10 points of damage.
So you pull this dagger out, jab it into your elbow, cut out this crawling worm up your arm, and it falls out. Put the dagger in your teeth, pull out this massive staff, and whack this thing. It had 10 hit points left.
Hell yeah.
It falls where it is, and there's, as it falls, like a dozen of these worms get pierced on the caltrops on the floor around it.
Hooray.
It starts sizzling.
Yeah, and they bake.
Worm bake.
Hooray.
One down.
Yep, that's one down. And I'm going to bonus action attack the other one.
Poop. All right.
With the wrong end of the stick. 11 to hit.
That's a hit.
And that's going to be 7 points of damage. That's pretty good, actually.
Got it.
Action surge.
This is when you do it. This is when you do it.
Yep. And he's going to continue thwacking the next one.
All right.
Just keep thwacking. Just keep thwacking.
Yes, exactly. 15 is going to be 9 points of damage.
All right.
Oh, with the 15 hits, I'm going to try to trip this one as well.
So that's a DC 15 strength.
Yes.
Saving strength check or saving
strength
throw?
Saving
that
throw.
That doesn't matter. Let's see.
Dang it.
15.
So that's a save.
Yes, if succeeds.
All right. So in addition to the 9 points of damage, it takes 8 more. So that's 17 points of damage from that attack.
17. All right.
And then the second attack of my new action surgery attack action. A 24, yep. And 9 points of damage there.
All right, you give this thing a thorough whopping.
Yep. And he's just like ew.
We should. Why are we should you get like some this? Of those worms to just apply to Fezzan in combat? He's really effective.
All right. Did your dude act?
I think he's going to take a step back. No. Yes, he's going to take another step back with his rest of his move action. And yeah, Thistle's going to take step to the side and shoot an arrow.
All right.
It's a d20 plus 4, 19.
Hit.
And with 8 points of damage.
All right.
And then he's going to step back around the corner with a nope.
And throw up in his mouth.
Yes.
All right. That was Fairzon. Tarathiel, it's your turn.
All right. Tarathiel's going to call out to the guys in the back of the room, stay back, which they already were. But... 15, 20.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank
good,
you.
Good. Yes, sir. I will do that.
All right, that's 20 feet of movement to there. I'm going to cross in front of where this last one is standing and throw a psychic dagger at it on the way past.
All right.
It's a 13 to hit for that's 5 good. Psychic damage. Keep moving.
Drive by attack.
See ya.
That's 30 to there, and then I will cunning action.
Stab Khaldun in the neck.
Keep going. I'll move to there.
Yeah. You are leaving. All right.
I figure I want to be on the opposite wall from where Khaldun is, just to try and hopefully give them multiple targets.
Yep.
All right. So this, you Khaldun and Tarathiel, you've moved into a pretty large cavern, but there's nothing. It's just a larger cavern. There doesn't seem to be anything else in here.
They're invisible.
I thought you were going to say surprise T-Rex. And we'll see you next week.
Yes. Right?
It's an invisible zombie T-Rex.
Those are the worst kind.
Invisible zombie T-Rex? No, I'd again? Rather not see it coming. Yeah, every room has an invisible zombie T-Rex. Sakura will fire an arrow from where he is. 12 to hit. No, nice. That's not how that works.
Nice. No, it is. That is how it works. That's fine.
That's deep. 5 piercing damage.
Did you add the +2? I'm not looking at the screen.
Yeah, I did. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
All right.
I did.
All right.
And he will step back up the corridor a little bit.
Okay. That's Trethiel. It is the top of round 3.
Are we all right? It 2 hours 15.
Yes. Right. Yeah. Top of round 3. Pazel is Pazel's turn. There's one of these zombies left. Khaldun has worms in his neck crawling up and getting closer every round to his brain. The three henchmen are freaking out and just stay as far away from this creature as possible. And yeah, it's over 2 hours, so we're going to have to call it and pick this fight up next week.
Dang it. Dang it.
Yeah.
Ew. Ew.
These lovely, lovely
creatures. The week
creatures.
Of worms.
Like, if we could go 5 more minutes and not have to deal with the worms next week, I'd be okay with it.
I don't know. You know, these things regenerate pretty quick. Uh-huh. It depends on how this round goes as to how much longer it takes.
Maybe I should have talked out of Khaldun on the way past.
How many rounds does Khaldun have left? You know, right. Don't know what's happening.
All right.
Hopefully more than
but
one.
But we'll find out next week.
Or you want to remind them about the interesting thing that's happening in the future?
What interesting thing?
Why don't you tell us what the interesting thing is, Jamie?
Yeah. Yes. What are you talking
about? The upcoming live stream.
Oh, yeah. So Rocks and Moonlords will be coming to its final episode soon. And that final episode, which probably fall around mid-July is what we're estimating. There may be a gap between the last recorded episode and the actual live episode as we get things ready. Because it will go long. It will be hours long recording. But it will be the final episode of Rocks and Moonlords. We'll be live streaming on Twitch for whoever would like to show up and participate in the fight. Because you know it's going to be a fight. As soon as we have a solid date, it's pretty dependent on Wes. He has a better idea of the time frame, but we will be announcing that everywhere. Probably Discord, definitely here. We on the Rocks and Moonlords podcast. Here, there, everywhere. We may even actually dust off the Twitter and throw a tweet out there talking about our last episode. Yeah, I know. So join us. It should be fun. We're all going to try to be in the same room instead of doing this tele-recording and you know, see how nervous we can make Wes doing a live recording with level 20 combat.
Six nervouses.
at least yeah. Six nervouses.
Minimum of six. Probably 7.
Disadvantage nervous. Thanks for joining us. We will see you next Monday, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard on that non-daylight savings time. Is it daylight savings?
Next one.
We're Barb. Twerp. No, what was the fire damage thing?
Doot.
Doot you next, doot. Dooters.
Doot you, doot, doot, doot. Yeah, no, we are now Doot Smurfs.
I'm pressing the ending button.
It's a sound policy for a happier universe.